Hello students, we are almost at the end of our first chapter, Knowing with Numbers. I hope you are practicing this chapter and there are few doubts asked by the children. So I will start with the doubts and then we will continue with the hot questions and other important questions today. So get ready with your book and pen. There was one correction needed in question number 4 B part, that this digit 491 was changed or round off to 500. Yes, so by mistake I have written 500 here. Children, make a correction in your work. Change this 500 into 490. Why 490? Because at ones place we have a digit smaller than 5 and we will change this digit directly into 0. Rest of the digits will remain same. Now let us take the doubt questions from MCQs. All of you come to page number 21, question number 6. Now in this question number 6, it is given the total number of 4 digit number. It's a very, very important question, children. We should here they are asking how many 4 digit numbers we have. Okay, so how to do this question? Whenever such question come, always start with the greatest 4 digit number. Which is our greatest 4 digit number? How do we write down 4 digit number, greatest 4 digit number? We simply write down 999 at every place value. Yes. Then write down the smallest 4 digit number. For smallest 4 digit number, we start with 1 and rest of the place value will occupy zeros. Now take the subtraction. Now when you subtract, what we have done, we are actually excluding 1000. So we want this 1000 to be added in our count. So therefore I have added plus 1 here and my total number is 9000. Okay, children. So which option is going to be correct? That is the A part. A part is our correct answer. Now these are two similar questions to question 6. These are very important. So make sure you practice them and find out how many 6 digit number are there, or calculate the number of 5 digit numbers. Yes, do. Now I will take next question, question number 12, on the next page. Now question 12 says we have to write the numbers from 1 to 100 and in those numbers how many times the 5 digit will come. Now look here, I have given written all the numbers here. In the first series, 1 to 10 series, how many times 5 come? It comes at only 5 place. Similarly, then 10 to 20, 15 comes. Then 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. I have written here 40 to 49. So these many times 5 comes. How many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have written 5 times here. Now when we are doing from 50 to 59, that series will come. Make sure that you are counting 5 2 times when the number 55 is written. Yes. Here we are counting how many times the digit 5 is written. Okay. Whether it is on tens place, ones place, we have to count both the places. Okay. So when you will write down from 50 to 59, make a count on your fingers and you will find that 11 times we have written 5 in this counting. When we start from 60 to 70, one time 5 appears. Then next number till 100 we have to reach. So how many times the 5 appears in this count? 4 times. Now let us add all of them. 5 plus 4, that is 9. 9 plus 11 is 20. So our answer D. So here D is the correct answer. Okay. Got the answer how we reach to this 20? Okay, now we will come to the thought questions. Here I have mentioned the homework which I will send you in a separate doc file also. Yes. Now children, whatever questions we are discussing in the video, same you will get as a doc file also. Images I will send to you. Okay. Now in HOTS question, question 1 to 3 were already given in the previous solution. There was doubt for question number 4. I am giving you the solution for this. But still, if you have doubt in HOT question from 1 to 3, do message me. Okay? We will discuss it. Question 4. How many times does the digit 3 occurs at tens place? Okay, children. Now, this question is similar to what we have just now discussed about 5 digit. In that question, place value was not fixed. 5 was appearing at any place value and we were counting it. But here we have to count the 3 digit to be at tens place, and the number is starting from 100 to 1000. Okay, 100 to 1000. And here I have circled tens. Look here. I have circled tens because this place value is fixed for which number? 3. Now when you will write down the series, you will see that the 3 will appear when 130 to 139, this number comes, or this series comes. And in this series, 3 comes 10 times. Okay, 10 numbers are there which will have 3 at tens place. Similarly, next 200 series, when it will come, that in 200 series, specifically from 230 to 239, the 3 will appear at tens place 10s time. Now, when you write down all the series till 900 to this 939, you will find that these series are 9 times. Okay, so this 10 is 9 times. Here I have written series also. 100 series, 200, 300, 400, till 900. So 9 times the series come. So total number become 90. And this is how we will write down our answer. I hope the HOT questions are clear to you. Now we will move on to the last collection of questions, that is check your progress on page number 23. Question 1 and 2 of the exercises homework. They are very simple question, writing names. We will start with answer 3. Look at the question. Find the difference between place value and face value of the digit 6 in the number this. See children, this is a kind of revision exercise. So here I have given you the how to write down this answer. When we are writing place value, we will simply write down the digit first, and whatever are the previous place value, we will write down that many zeros. So this is how we write down the place value. And face value is always the digit or the number itself. So 6 is the face value and we will do the subtraction here. Now coming to the next question, write all possible 2-digit number using the digit 4 and 0. Yes, that is also a homework. A very easy question. Try to do it. If you have any doubt, we will discuss it in the next class. Now we will come to question number 9. Children, those questions which we are leaving in between, they are part of your homework. Yes, they are like one word answer, and try to do them yourself. Now in question number 9, find the difference between greatest and the smallest 4-digit number formed by these given digits. This I have already explained you. Whenever such digits are given to you, for writing greatest number, start with the biggest digit and keep on decreasing decreasing your digit value. So I have kept on decreasing my digit value to get my largest number or greatest number. When it comes to smallest number, start with the smallest digit. Now here you will say smallest digit is 0. If I will start my number with 0, it won't be counted as 4 digit number. So how should I write down? To count it as a 4 digit number, I will write down 3, which is the next smallest digit, and then write down 0. And keep on increasing the digit value, you will get your smallest digit number. Now as the question says, find the difference. So you have to find the difference. Underline the word difference here. You know, sometimes in the exam, you might be asked to find the difference or to find the product or to find the sum. So careful with the operation required in the question. Yes, you will be able to score full marks only when you are reading your question carefully and you are writing the digits carefully. Okay, children. Now let us move on to the next question. Now question number 10, I have given a hint here. Find the sum, underline the word sum, of the greatest, underline greatest, and the smallest 6-digit number formed by the digits these. Now here clearly it is given digit, use each digit only once, means you can't repeat the digits. Yes, while writing greatest number, we will start with the greater digit and keep on decreasing your digit. And while writing the smallest number, write down the smallest digit one first. Now here 0 is the smallest digit. I can't write it once at this value because my number will become 5 digit. So I will write down 2 as my first smallest digit and then 0, 4, 5, 6, 7 till it you reaches to your greater digits and then simply add. Now let us look at the hint of question number 11. Now question number 11 says, find the sum of 4 digit greatest number and 5 digit smallest number. Each number have 3 different digits. Now listen children, whenever such questions come, write down the greatest digit. Okay, greatest digits are 9, 8, 7. Okay, now here they are saying 3 different. So 3 different will be 9, 8 and 7. And smaller digits are, they start from 0, 1, 2, 3. And for me, the first 3 will be counted as the smallest digit for this particular question. So write down the 5 digit smaller number. So 5 digit smaller number will not start from 0. Otherwise it won't be counted as 4, it won't be counted as 5 digit number. I will start with 1, then put as many zeros. Here I have written 3 0, 1, 0, 0 and again 0. There is small correction here, so carefully note down this. This is 1, 0, 0, 0 and the last, that is the third digit I have written here, 2. Yes children. Now to write down the 4 digit largest number, we start our largest number with greatest digit, which is 9 here. Okay, 9, and here I am repeating it 9 again because they have told me to use only 3 digits and I have already told you my 3 digits are 9, 8 and 7. If I will write down 8 here, then I have to think about one more digit which will reduce my number. Okay, so what I am doing to write down my largest number, I am writing my biggest digit, that is 9, 2 times and rest of the 2 places are occupied by other 2 digits. Yes, and do the addition of this these numbers yourself, do the calculation yourself. Now, next question is question number 12. Write the greatest and the smallest 4-digit number using 4 different digits. And here the condition given is that digit should be a digit 3 is always at 100 place. Now look here, I have written THHTO to avoid any confusion, because it is said it should be a 4 digit number. So I have written the place values here. Now while writing a 4 digit number, they are saying 3 to be kept at 100 place. So for both greatest and the smallest number, I have fixed the digit. Greatest number. For greatest number, the bigger digits available with me are 9, 8 and 7. So 9 will come here. I can't do anything with this place value. It is fixed. Now less than 9, the next smaller digit is 8 and less than 8 is 7. So this is how we will make the number. Now question 12 and 13 are almost same. You just follow the steps given here. Yes. Now let us move on to question number 15. In question number 15, to stitch a uniform. A uniform means one uniform. 1 meter 75 cloth is needed. Underline this data. Out of 153 meter cloth, how many uniforms can be stitched and how much cloth will remain? I have shown the hint here. Whenever we have a total amount and we are dividing it into one uniform. Okay, with this much length of cloth, you are making uniform of 175 centimeter. Now here, because meter and centimeter both were there in the question, so try to convert them into one unit. So meter is converted into centimeter. Here also meter is converted into centimeter, and then the final calculation is done. Now because we are dividing our one big cloth into 1111 uniform, I am using division operation. Here I have given you the hint. When you are doing the calculation, quotient will give you the number of uniform and remainder will give you the cloth left behind. I will be giving you hint for 16 and 17 also. Try to go through the solutions. If there is any doubt, I am going to clear it. And I hope the whole chapter is now simplified for you. You know each and every concept of it. Revise it thoroughly. Maybe in 1 or 2 days, you will get a message regarding the test for this chapter. So start preparing really well for this chapter.